right, thank you so much, John. We have some dogs that are doing some really, really great work for some people who did some amazing work for this country. To tell us about Dogs for Our Brave and their new headquarters in Dogtown, of all places, we have Paul Simone. He's a certified dog trainer. First of all, tell us who our friends are here and tell us a little bit about their story.
Sure, this is Holly and Alice.
Hey guys.
We've had them in our program for a little under 8 months now. Mm-hmm. They were rescued kind of from a neglect situation, kind of from an old farm. So we went out there and took a look at them and decided that we want them. They've been amazing. Obviously, they're pretty relaxed.
Yeah, very, very, very chill. I think it's ironic that that they came from a rescue situation and they're helping wounded warriors. Can you tell me about Dogs for Our Brave?
Yeah, so we try to rescue whenever we can. A lot of service companies, and they tend to raise them up from puppies, but we try to rescue whenever we can. So we basically provide service dogs to veterans at no cost to them at all. So that's the entire lifetime of the dog. So that's everything medical, all their training, food, travel, you name it.
Wow. So. And what kind of tasks, because I know that every wounded warrior is different and has different needs. Can you tell me a little bit about some of the needs that they provide, that the service animals provide for the wounded warriors?
Yeah, absolutely. Mostly, for people that have physical disabilities, they need help with pulling their wheelchair around or picking up an item when they drop it. Things that seem simple to us, but it can, be problematic if you drop your car keys and you're in your wheelchair and you're in the grocery store. So stuff like that.
No, absolutely. Sometimes those little things can make a huge difference in your entire day, whether or not you're able to complete your to-do list for that day. You guys have a brand new open house.
We do.
Can you tell me how that, I'm sorry, you have an open house coming up for your new
yep.
headquarters. How will the headquarters help you do your job?
Yeah, so we just got into our new headquarters in Dogtown. We're at 6244 Clayton Avenue. This Thursday, we have an open house from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. And it's just an open air facility that we've pretty much designed so that we have a lot of areas to train the dogs and teach them everything they need for the tasks that they're required to do.
And another thing I want to ask you, just one more question. They have little patches on them that says, do not pet. Can you mm-hmm. tell me why working dogs should not be petted, at least without permission?
Yeah, absolutely. So when you see a working dog when you're out, you shouldn't try to come over and pet it. Any dog without permission in
any
general.
Any dog, period. That's true, yeah.
But service animals in particular are not supposed to be being pet whenever they're out because they're actually working. They're performing a task. And you don't want them to get overexcited because it'll distract them from what they're supposed to be doing. So it is an important thing to follow.
And definitely some of the tasks that they perform are life-saving for the people that they work with, right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
All right, everybody, we have the Dogs for Our Brave open house. That's gonna be this Thursday from 4 until 8, 6244 Clayton Avenue, again in Dogtown, of all places, which I think is so cool. Just call 314-517-4993. To learn more about Dogs for Our Brave, go to dogsforourbrave.com. These guys are chilling right now, but they're working dogs here on the 9 a.m. show.